Hello, I'm Charles Fisher of FishTech.com. This is your weekly video fish report, and even after a blowout win, there are things that we can learn. Let's take a look. Was that the most revealing blowout win in years? I was surprised at some of the things I learned about our offense beyond the obvious about our new quarterback that the other media focused upon. There were some notable changes in our play calling, and we will ponder the reasons for it, and we'll address an amusing new defensive alignment that Oregon fans will see often this season. Naturally, all of this will be demonstrated in high-definition video examples as always. This has to be one of the most interesting lopsided Oregon games in recent memory, and it's fun to get the season started with new players and new game footage to work with. One of the biggest surprises of the Oregon offense is the amount of youth on it. Watch again as we see Tyler Johnstone in his first collegiate play make a great block on the linebacker. We had sophomores starting who had extensive experience in Grasso and Fisher, but it's not like they're three-year experienced seniors. We know Colt Liera, but he did not start last year and had limited experience, yet here he is as a newbie sophomore starter. Now we get a redshirt freshman quarterback who has another redshirt freshman protecting his blindside and left tackle Johnstone. My friends, that is six sophomore or freshmen starting, over half the offense, and we're supposed to have a blockbuster offense? Most teams losing their star running back and starting quarterback would clearly be in a rebuilding mode, yet here we are in the top five nationally with more youth starting and coming into play than I can ever remember. Most of the media has noticed after the fact that so many freshmen came in and played, and none looked at all at the inexperience among the starters. I was stunned at the youth starting and equally surprised at how well they played. The youth movement continued as we see Hamani Stevens in the game early on with his scoring drive. Look at the block of true freshman Dwayne Stanford on a straddle triple option. This touchdown occurs because of a great block by the slot receiver true freshman Braylon Addison. This is not garbage time, it is when it counts in a game. Is the freshman parade going to end? The short answer is no, as one freshman, Marcus Mariota, helps another, Farrell Brown, get into position. Look how the 6'6 tight end towers over the rest of the huddle. And here is another true freshman tight end, Koa Kaua'i, make a great block in an outside zone read for Dap. We love it! It was a thrill to see Oregon native Keenan Lowe snag some nice passes, but also see him work to sustain his blocks. This touchdown doesn't happen without him fighting to keep his defender from making the tackle. It makes you want to run out there and hug the guy. Hey, look at my cool new Nike shirt with fishduck.com on it, made by our friends at Identity Zone.
Charles, we provide schools, companies, and events with screen printed and embroidered apparel found on our website. Identity Zone produces hats, shirts, and promotional items, and we ship anywhere.
I know you've created some large orders in the past for the Pendleton Roundup and the Duck Athletic Fund, but wasn't there a special batch you made?
Oh, it's been our great pleasure working with Kenny Wheaton and his foundation on camps and shirts like The Pick found on thousands of Duck fans everywhere.
Beautiful work done for all size groups. Go check Identity Zone today. Is the shift to so many young guns hinting at a shift in our offense? Everyone knows we're a run-first spread offense, but I was surprised when I charted the plays up until halfway through the second quarter when it was 50-3. We had run 24 pass plays to 19 running plays. We had 170 yards from rushing and 182 from passing. Wow! Are we becoming more of a passing team, thus more balanced to the offense? It's too early to know, but we did end the game at nearly balanced yardage of 297 to 308, and that becomes very ominous to defensive coordinators when we open the playbook more. The fact is, Super Mario is very accurate, and that helps the pocket passing game without depending entirely upon play-action passes. This is an exciting development to monitor as we watch the play calling and the balance in yardage as the season progresses. This could be a huge shift in the Chip Kelly era. I love the new uniforms, and it's so cool to see yellow pants and helmets again, especially these helmets. Forget Kansas. If you click these, you gotta return to Oregon. The grizzled old coach pointed out the difficulty Lara has with this block. We're running a sweep read to the right, and he's got the seal, or pin the defender, inside when he's actually lined up outside of Colt. Colt did pretty darn good with it regardless. This time they want to run the sweep read to the right, but the defender is way out there to stop it, and that's an impossible block to make, trying to get him inside. So we have Colt block down or inside and pull the tackle Fisher, who blocks outside and creates a gap in between. Touchdown, baby. A defense we've run on second or third and long is the three-duck chuck, and we morph into it on this play. Sometimes the quarterback gets loosed for the first down, unfortunately. So a few years back, we began a variation of it that I call the I-Spy-3, where you clearly see the nose tackle tag the offensive lineman in front of him as he operates as a spy to stop the quarterback scrambles. Here in the Rose Bowl, we morphed into it as well, and it works. When you're only rushing two, preventing a quarterback scramble with a third, it's hard to complete a pass against an eight-man zone, as in this play. It's a defense that drives some fans crazy, but on a percentage basis, it really does work. As we get leads on teams over the season, you'll see this quite a bit. Look for the three-duck chuck and the I-Spy-3 on long yardage situations, and note our success rate. Do the coaches call them these names? No, but I have to have a little fun as I learn this stuff, and it makes it easier for me to remember. It is interesting how we're seeing new tendencies from Oregon already with all the underclassmen playing, the shift toward more of a balanced offense, as well as detecting these long yardage defensive alignments. A new year and more fun learning about Oregon football.
Oh, how we love to learn about our beloved Ducks. I'm Charles Fisher, Fish Duck, and to learn more about Oregon football, come to fishduck.com.